On page 55 of our textbook, our leader talks about divine science being the comforter as prophesied of in the Bible. Pretty important stuff. So I decided to delve into the pastor and really learn more about the comforter. Proverbs, my son, forget not my law, but let thine heart keep my commandments. For length of days and long life and peace shall they add to thee. Let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them about thy neck. Write them upon the table of thine heart. So shalt thou find favor and good understanding in the sight of God and man. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Matthew, be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father which is in heaven is perfect. John, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. And of his fullness have all we received, and grace for grace. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. And seeing the multitudes, he went up into a mountain. And when he was set, his disciples came unto him, and he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle shall in no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled. Therefore, I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body what ye shall put on. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or wherewithal shall we be clothed? For your heavenly Father knoweth that ye have need of all these things. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Therefore, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man, which built his house upon a rock, and the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon that house, and it fell not, for it was founded upon a rock. And it came to pass, when Jesus had ended these sayings, the people were astonished at his doctrine, for he taught them as one having authority and not as the scribes. John, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. And whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If ye shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. If ye love me, keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But ye know him, for he dwelleth with you, and shall be in you. I will not leave you comfortless. These things I have spoken unto you, because yet being present with you. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things, and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. And correlative passages from our textbook. As adherents of truth, we take the inspired word of the Bible as our sufficient guide to eternal life. God is individual, incorporeal. He is divine principle, love, the universal cause, the only creator. And there is no other self-existence. He is all-inclusive and is reflected by all that is real and eternal and by nothing else. He fills all space, and it is impossible to conceive of such omnipresence and individuality except as infinite spirit or mind. Hence, all is spirit and spiritual. Life, truth, and love constitute the triune person called God, that is the triply divine principle love. They represent a trinity in unity, three in one, the same in essence, though multiform in office. God, the Father, Mother, Christ, the spiritual idea of sonship, divine science, or the Holy Comforter. These three express in divine science the threefold essential nature of the infinite. The term Christian Science was introduced by the author to designate the scientific system of divine healing. The revelation consists of two parts: the discovery of this divine science of mind healing through a spiritual sense of the scriptures and through the teachings of the Comforter as promised by the Master, the proof by present demonstration that the so-called miracles of Jesus did not specially belong to a dispensation now ended, but that they illustrated an ever-operative divine principle. Christian Science differs from material science, but not on that account is it less scientific. On the contrary, Christian Science is preeminently scientific, being based on truth, the principle of all science. Physical science, so-called, is human knowledge, a law of mortal mind, a blind belief. This is a mortal, finite sense of things, which immortal spirit silences forever. This belief mistakes effect for cause and seeks to find life and intelligence in matter, thus limiting life and holding fast to discord and death. In a word, human belief is a blind conclusion from the material reasoning. The universe, like man, is to be interpreted by science from its divine principle, God. And then it can be understood. Spirit is the life, substance, and continuity of all things. There is no physical science, inasmuch as all truth proceeds from the divine mind. Therefore, truth is not human. It is not a law of matter, for matter is not a lawgiver. Science is an emanation of divine mind and is alone able to interpret God aright. It has a spiritual and not a material origin. It is a divine utterance, the Comforter, which leadeth into all truth. Jesus was a son of a virgin. He was appointed to speak God's word and to appear to mortals in such a form of humanity as they could understand as well as perceive. Jesus demonstrated Christ. He proves that Christ is the divine idea of God, the Holy Ghost or Comforter, revealing the divine principle love and leading into all truth. Our Master said, "But the Comforter shall teach you all things." When the science of Christianity appears, it will lead you into all truth. The Sermon on the Mount is the essence of this science, and the eternal life, not the death of Jesus, is its outcome. We acknowledge and adore one supreme and infinite God. We acknowledge his Son, one Christ, the Holy Ghost, the divine comforter, and man in God's image and likeness. In the words of St. John, "He shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. This comforter I understand to be divine science."